So the topic is assessing the biological and mechanical quality of the implant bone complex using medical microtechnologies. Reconstruction of bone atrophies and rehabilitation using dental implants are often evaluated based on biological aspects. As a reconstructed jaw also has to ensure primary implant stability, the goals of this study were to determine the mechanical quality of regenerated bone and to investigate potential correlations of intraoperative bone density, testing of morphological variables of stability of dental implants inserted in the lower jaw as an experimental model simulating human clinical situations. As a material method, we had 10 adult mini pigs, 2 years old, and a mean body weight of 47 kilograms. Totally, we used 40 dental implants from two manufacturers, 16 bone level dental implants of diameter 3.3 and the length of 8 millimeters of an selective surface by Straumann, Switzerland. 24 dental implants, noble parallel conical connection, narrow platform of diameter 3.75 and the length of 7 millimeters from Noble Biocare, Switzerland. As a bone substitute, we used autogenous bone and two xenografts. One was a spongious bone substitute as a demineralized bovine bone mineral bios in combination with a resorbable bilayer membrane bioguide Geistlich Pharma, Switzerland, as well as deproteinized bovine mineralized bone matrix, Creox Xenogain, in combination with resorbable long cross-linked collagen membrane, Creox Xenoprotect from Noble Biocare, Switzerland. We divided animals in according to the experiments in two major groups. For the first animals, we did the bilateral extraction of the lower premolars and vertical alveolar bone reduction. After healing of period of 3 months, insertion of two dental implants for each part of the mandible was performed four implants for each animal by 3.38 millimeters length Straumann selective. Maximum implant insertion torque force was measured with the surgical motor iShiro Pro, the special program used for Apple by BNR Switzerland. Primary implant stability was measured by means of resonance frequency analysis using an Austell Mentor device and implant-specific smart bag abutments for single use from company Austell Göteborg, Sweden. A special attention was done for extraction of the teeth in the mini pigs because of the morphology. The anatomical particularities of these roots are much thinner than in humans, and they can have different curvatures. So to avoid complications like apex fracture, we decided to cut the crowns in two parts and to extract each crown separately. In comparison of the humans, premolars, in this case, they have two roots, and in humans, we have just only one root. The surgical procedure for the implant placement was performed after 3 months. We did flap opening on the mid-crystal incision of the lower jaw. It was grinding of the any reminiscences of the bone. First, we used a round bore, and then we used two drills, 2.2 and 2.8 millimeters pilot drills, and finished with the profile drill. Implant placement was made using the surgical motor, and we used for the flap closure interrupted the resorbable vicryl sutures number 50. A second lot of experiments was performed in 6 mini pigs. Here we did the bilateral extraction of all mandibular premolars, followed by healing period of 3 months. A total of 4 study sites were available in each animal. In one site per animal, native bone was maintained, serving as a control group native, while 3 walled cylindrical defects with oral deficiencies were created in the remaining sites using a refined reel of a diameter of 6 millimeters from Neo Auto Chip Marker, Neo Biotech Korea. These defects were augmented in a randomized manner using the following materials: autogenous bone chips harvesting during defect preparation, autogenous group, demineralized bovine bone mineral bios in combination of resorbable bilayer membrane bioguide. And the last one, but not the least, deproteinized bovine mineralized bone matrix, Creox Xenogain, Noble Biocare, in combination of resorbable collagen membrane, Creos Xenoprotein System from Noble Biocare, group Creos. And here is a schematical and some clinical pictures after defect creation. And you can see here on this picture, for each defect, we use different mini screws for osteosynthesis to randomize the defect. Covering of the defects of the bone, substitute, and membranes. And of course, we performed X-ray and computer tomography after each surgical procedures in order to see the volumetric changes of the augmented site. Images of the 3D reconstruction of defects were made especially prior for implant placement because to study the morphological changes of the different bone substitutes and bone formation. As well, we during implant placement, we performed, we took some bone for some bone chips for the histological analysis and to see from each group, for example, a group of BIOS and group of CREOS according to the defect of autogen and nothing. Implant placement, two animals each were allowed to heal for 12, 18, and 24 weeks, respectively, prior to implant surgery. Implant site preparation was done using the implant manufacturer's protocol, 2 millimeter twist drill and continue 2.4 in the apex and 2.8 millimeter twist drill in the neck. Compressive testing of the both cortical dense and trabecular soft bone surrounding the implant site was performed using the bone probe device. The implant sites were finalized using the implant manufacturer's 2.8 in the apex and 3.2 millimeters in the neck twist step drill. During drilling process, bone samples were obtained from a morphological evaluation of augmented sites. One titanium implant, of parallel conical connection of diameter 3.75 and length 7 millimeters from Noble Biocare was placed into each study site using a surgical motor iShiro Pro for determining maximum implant insertion torque. Primary implant stability was measured as well as by means of resonance of frequency analysis of device OSTEL. Histomorphometric and macroradiographic analysis after 18 weeks after sacrification. All bone specimens were fixed in 10% formalin solution for 48 hours and reduced to rectangular blocks using a diamond bone saw using a device exact germanium. After that, the specimens were dehydrated in alcohol solution of increasing concentration and embedded in the polymethyl methacrylate technovit herauskulz, the germanium. One buccal lingual section parallel to the long axis of the implant was obtained per specimen by a cutting and grinding technique. With the section reduced to a thickness of 120 micrometers, microradiographs were obtained of the device Carestream Healthcare, USA. Following further reduction to the thickness of 70 micrometers and staining with toluidine blue solution, bone implant contact was measured histomorphometrically using a microscope Leica Germany, equipped to color image analyzing system Leica microsystem vertebral. Here we have some clinical, radiological pictures in comparison of histological comparison. Special attention we address to contact of the body of the implant to the newborn, as well as formation of the new bone around the body of the implant, as well as a possible of the microfractures of the bone during implant insertion. As well, very important, what we studied in the part where the implant was not covered, was not possible to cover fully in the bone. We studied the vertical bone formation around the neck of the implant. A significant positive correlation was found between the parameters of the bone implant contact, bone mineral density, and implant primary stability at different time points. While bone substitute materials may differ in their biological performance, the difference in mechanical properties of regenerated bone clinically determining primary implant stability seems to be minor. Intraoperative compressive testing of bone correlation with insertion torque measurements to some extent but allows for the adaptation of the surgical protocol to be made prior to implant placement. And with the limitation of this study and the weak correlation of the bone probe measurement found with insertion torque values of specific implant system, this diagnostic device may be useful for predicting implant stability at the stage where the clinician is still able to modify the surgical and prosthetic treatment plan. Thank you very much for attention.
Thank you. the presentation. Samuel, have any questions?
Well, I would have one question, more of curiosity. First of all, I want to congratulate you for your presentation and your work, which is a very applicative one. My curiosity is about how you manage the implanted model animal. You had to change the feeding procedures or something like that?
Well, the story
to
the
protect
story,
the implant.
Yeah, the story for this model is very hard to maintain. We had before this model, we did a lot of models in mini pigs, and it was very hard because we used the standard implant which was made for humans. The problem with the standard implants for the humans, we have a larger prosthetic part where we put the crown inside. So here was a problem because they were chewing with these implants and everything was destroyed. And we recently published a paper because this model is not suitable for classical dental implants for patients. So this implant, we cannot restore prosthetically. So this implant we need to put under the bone and to completely close the soft. Because if you put, like we use in the humans, and put them the crown or something, a screw, then they will chew this and they will destroy everything.
Okay, thank you.
Actually was took like 5 or 6 years to come to this model.
Okay, thank you.